It's a victory day, everybody. Why don't you go ahead and type that into the chat? High five your virtual neighbor. Tell them it's a victory day. And is there anybody this morning that's grateful for the reckless love of God? I mean, you know, when you were way out there, the love of God came and snatched you from wherever you are. I just want you to put it in the chat. Thank you for the love of God. Before I spoke a word, you were singing over me. You've been so, so good to me. Before I took a breath, you breathed your life in me. You've been so, so kind to me. Oh, the overwhelming, never-ending, reckless love of God. Oh, it chases me down, fights till I'm found, leaves the 99. I couldn't earn it, and I don't deserve it, but still you give yourself away. Oh, the overwhelming, never-ending, reckless love of God. Hallelujah, Jesus. It's the reckless love of God. Whoa. Anybody grateful for the love? Somebody say, when I was your foe, you still fought for me. You've been so, been so, so good to me. When I felt no worth, you paid it all, you paid it all. You've been so, so. Say, oh, the over, never ending, reckless love of God. Say, oh, it chases and it finds till I'm found, leaves the 99. And I don't deserve it, I couldn't earn it, but still you give yourself away. Oh, the overwhelming, never-ending, reckless love of God. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Lord, I'm grateful for your love. There's no shadow you won't light up, mountain you won't climb up, coming after me. There's no wall you won't kick down, lie you won't tear down, coming after me. There's no shadow, mountain you won't, coming after me, God. There's no wall you won't kick down, now you won't tear down, coming after me. There's no shadow, say, mountain you won't, coming after me, God. There's no wall you won't kick down, now you won't tear down. Oh, the over, reckless love of God. Oh, it chases me down, fights till I'm found, leaves the 99. I couldn't, still you give, Oh, the over, never-ending, reckless love of God. It's the reckless love of God. And I'm grateful for your love. Hallelujah. Yay!
Well, hey, 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 VGC, it's a victory day. Come on, put it in the chat. It's a victory day. Come on, faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Let me know you can hear me by putting it in the chat or putting a heart over your head. It's a victory day, and it's our year of release. Come on, put it in the chat. It's our victory day, and it's our year of release. Good to see everybody. VGC in the DMV, digitally, locally, globally. Come on, God bless you. Good to see each one of you. And I trust everybody is remaining safe and secure. And this year, Dr. Butler, we believe in God for victory at home. I dare you to put it in the chat. Victory at home. Where is it going to be, John? Victory at home. Venus, where is it going to be? Victory at home. Sister Tucker, where is it going to be? Victory at home. Paul and Elaine, victory at home. Dr. Young and her sister, victory at home. Come on, put it in the chat. Victory is coming to my house. My God, victory is coming to my house. And if you're born in the month of August, we want to wish you a happy birthday. If you have something to celebrate in the month of August, we are celebrating with you. But thanks for joining us for what we are calling for the next 7 weeks, the road to DeMaskUs. Would you put it in the chat? I'm on the road to DeMaskUs. I'm on a road, and the road is called DeMaskUs. Let's have a word of prayer. Father, thank you for who you are. Thank you for showing yourself strong and mighty. Let the words of our mouths and the meditations of our hearts be acceptable in your sight. For indeed you are rock and our redeemer. In Jesus' name we pray, and we say amen and amen and amen. Well, let's get into the word of God. We are in the book of Acts chapter 9. Acts chapter 9. Acts chapter 9. We are in a wonderful scripture. Acts chapter 9. And if you have not yet join us, we want to encourage you to join us as we are reading through the book of Acts. We are reading through the book of Acts, but for the next 7 weeks, we are in Acts chapter 9 because we are on the road to DeMaskUs. And in Acts chapter 9, particularly reading at verse number 1, Sister Lacey, it reads, meanwhile, Saul was still breathing out murderous threat against the Lord's disciple. He went to the high priest and asked him for letters to the synagogue in DeMaskUs so that if he found any there who belonged to the way, give me the word way, whether men or women, he might take them as prisoners to Jerusalem. As he neared DeMaskUs, give me the word DeMaskUs, as he neared DeMaskUs on his journey, suddenly a light from heaven flashed around him. He fell to the ground, heard a voice says to him, Saul, Saul, why do you persecute me? Who are you? Somebody asked that question in the chat. Who are you, Lord? Saul asked. I am Jesus whom you are persecuting, he replied. Now get up and go into the city, and you will be told what you must do. The man traveling with Saul, I'm in verse 7 for today. The man traveling with Saul stood there speechless. They heard the sound, but did not see anyone. Saul got up from the ground, but when he opened his eyes, he could see nothing. So they led him by the hand into DeMaskUs. For 3 days, give me the number 3, Miss Marvella. For 3 days, he was blind. He did not eat or drink anything. Look at verse 10. In DeMaskUs, there was a disciple named Ananias. The Lord called to him in a vision. He replied, yes, Lord. The Lord told him, go to the house of Judas on Straight Street. Don't miss that, Brother Monroe, on Straight Street. Somebody put it in the chat. I'm shooting straight because I'm on straight street. Ah, come on, I'm in the straight street. And ask for a man from Tarshish named Saul, for he is plain. And in a vision, he has seen a man named Ananias come and place his hand on him to restore his sight. My goodness, verse 15. But the Lord says to this disciple, go, this man is my chosen instrument to proclaim my name to the Gentiles. Hey, for the time I have, John, I want to talk about I'm on a crossroad. Come on, put it in the chat. All of us who have ever traveled, have you ever been cashier, got to a crossroad? Oftentimes when you are traveling, all of us know there's one or two ways that you can get to your destiny. How many, Reverend Brittany? There's one or two ways that you and I can get to our destiny. Most of the time when you're traveling to a different city, Ella Johnson, there is a way that they call the long way. Give me the word long. There is a way that is short, and there's the way where you have to pay toll, and then there is the way that is absolutely free. Well, on every path that you and I are going to take, we will sometime encounter, Tasha, what is called a crossroad. Last week, we saw Paul as Saul, and his mission as Saul was to find those who were called people of the way, or who we call today Christians. You see, in the early church, the believers were not called Christians. They were called people of the way. Come on, put it in the chat. I'm a person of the way. They are people of the way, or what we would call Christians. And his job as Saul was to find all of those people who were people of the way to persecute them and to kill them. You see, Paul was the protector of the old establishment or the Jewish religion. This story of Paul on the road to Damascus is found in three places in the Bible. It is found, first of all, in Acts chapter 9. Give it back to me. Secondly, it is found in Acts chapter 22. And thirdly, it is found in Acts chapter 26. There's three places where you will encounter this story that is in this Bible. Acts chapter 9 is the story. Acts chapter 22. Paul rehearsed the story, and in Acts chapter 26, he tells the story again. That teaches you a profound principle, Solomon, and that is you should always tell your story. Put it in the chat. What did I say? You should always tell your story. Don't let anybody tell your story. The songwriter said, this is my story. This is my song. Praising my Savior all the day long. Your job, if God has done anything for you, come on, put it in the chat. You got to tell it. The only people who shouldn't post it on Facebook, the only people who shouldn't post it on IG, the only person who shouldn't post it on YouTube, the only person who shouldn't post it on Snapchat or WhatsApp is the people who have not experienced anything that the Lord has done for them. But if the Lord brought you out, and if the Lord brought you in, and if the Lord brought you over, come on, put it in the chat. I gotta tell my story, whether I text it, whether I tweet it, whether I sing it, whether I preach it, whether I wave my hand. I've got to tell my story, because Jeremiah said, it's like fire. Come on, put it in the chat. What is it? It's like fire shut up in my bone. Paul encounter had such a powerful encounter that Paul kept on telling his story over and over and over again. And may I ask you a question? When last have you told your story? And who have you told your story to? The world is telling their story. People in the world are telling the story. And yet church folks are not telling the greatest story. The greatest story is, I was blind, but now I can see. I was lost, and now I'm found. I was dead, but Jesus picked me up and turned me around. How dare you experience the power of God and you keep it to yourself? I need somebody to put it in the chat. I gotta tell somebody. Whether you're on the golf course, you gotta tell somebody. Whether you are in the mall, you got to tell somebody. Whether you're on the grocery store, you got to tell somebody. What will happen if everybody at the sound of my voice made a decision that before today ends or before this week is over, I'm going to tell somebody. Well, how do I tell my story? Your story come part of three things. How many? Three things. Number one, your story starts with I once was. Come on, I once was. I'm going to tell you how to tell your story. You don't even have to open your Bible. You don't even have to quote scripture. Your story starts off with I once was. And then you move from I once was to then Jesus. Come on. My goodness. Then Jesus. I was lost. I was a mess. I couldn't sleep. I was angry. I was bitter. I was lost in my sin. I was lost in my persecution. But then Jesus. Come on. Put it in the chat. Then Jesus. Then Jesus showed up. Then Jesus made a difference. Then Jesus. And the third part of your story is since then. What did I say? Come on, put it in. Since then, since I had Jesus, since I had an encounter with Jesus, my life has never been the same. That's your assignment this week, is to tell somebody I was, and then Jesus, and then since then. What did I say? I was, and then Jesus, but since then. Your job as the believer is to tell your family, everybody in your household, everybody that you connected with, everybody who follows you on Twitter or follow you on IG, you're to tell them your story. And this is what Paul did over and over again. He kept on telling the story, and the story is what he experienced on the road to Damascus. Now, this trip that Paul is taking and you and I are taking is not a getaway. Come on, Dr. Younger just got down from Puerto Rico. This is not a trip to Puerto Rico. Put in the chat where you've been lately. Some of y'all just got back from Jamaica. My son just got back from Mexico. I just got back from my garage. Come on, put it in the chat. Where have you been lately? Some of you just got back. My goodness, you all over the country. Paul, this trip that Paul is taking is not a vocational trip, and it is not a quick trip. It requires a lot of planning and resources, because you see, in order for you to leave Jerusalem where Paul is and to travel to Damascus, it's 140 miles. How many? It's 140 miles from Jerusalem to Damascus. This trip, Solomon, is equivalent to leaving San Diego and going to Los Angeles, where the West Coast folks at. This trip, Bill Wormley, is like leaving Maryland and going to Charlotte, North Carolina. Antoinette, this trip is like leaving Maryland and going to New York. Now, remember, they are not traveling on plane and they're not traveling on train. They are traveling on foot. Come on, put it in the chat. They're not traveling on plane. They are not traveling on any Amtrak. They are not traveling on boats, but they rather traveling on foot. And by the way, it's no modern roads. There is no paved road. It's rocky road. It will take Paul 2 weeks. Somebody give me the number two. It will take Paul 2 weeks to get there and 2 weeks to return home. For that simply reason, John Paul is not traveling by himself. Oh my goodness. Billy, look at the sister next to you. And said, this trip is not a solo trip. Paul is not traveling by himself. Life is more meaningful when you got company. Did y'all catch that? Put it in the chat. Life is more meaningful when you got company. Life is more beneficial, John, when you got company. You don't want to travel by yourself. Life is more meaningful when you got family and friends, when you got people who get you, Susan. Life is more meaningful, Daniel, when you got company. And on this road to Damascus, the Bible says, as Paul is traveling with his friends and traveling with the company, the Bible said that a light shines from heaven. Saul falls off of his horse, because most likely he's traveling on a horse. He falls off of his high horse. Ooh, Did y'all catch a revelation? He fall off of his high horse. The first step on the road to Damascus is you got to swallow your pride. I wish somebody put it in the chat. Martha, the first step to Damascus is sometimes God has to knock you off of your high horse. Who am I talking to? You think too highly of yourself. You think you're all that, a bag of chips and some dip. But God will allow a pandemic. God will allow a situation. God will allow a divorce. God will allow, I did not say God did it. I said God will allow it to just knock that, my goodness, pride off of you. The Bible said that God resists the proud, but he give grace to the humble. Come on, put it in the chat. I'm eating humble pie. Oh my goodness, Paul was riding high. He was full of himself. He was arrogant and conceited. But on the road to Damascus, God knocked him off of his high horse. I don't know who I came to preach to this morning, but God wants you to know, don't feel bad if he had to knock you off of your high horse, because the Bible said humility comes before promotion. Did y'all catch a revelation? What did I say? I said humility comes before promotion. Are you ready for your promotion? Well, the way up is the way down. Put it in the chat. I said the way up is the way down. If you were to humble yourself under the mighty hand of God, come on, he will exalt you in due season. Somebody put it in the chat. I got to humble myself. Come on, put it in the chat. I've got to humble myself under the mighty hand of God, because God will exalt me in due season. The Bible said that Paul is riding higher. My goodness, he's full of himself, and he's locating those who are part of the way. And the Bible said that as he's riding high, there is a light that comes, knocks him off of his high horse. He falls on the ground, and he hears the voice of the Lord. I'm in Acts chapter 9. He hears the voice of the Lord. My goodness. And the Bible says, as Paul is knocked down, from the light came a voice that said, Saul, Saul, why are you persecuting me? Saul attempted to make sense of what is Acts. And so Saul responded in verse 5. He said, who are you, Lord? Don't miss that, Deacon Elaine. He said, who are you, Lord? Did you catch that, Reverend Brittany? He already know who he is. He said, who are you, Lord? My goodness. He said, who are you, Lord? My goodness. He said, who are you? And the voice revealed, I am Jesus, the one that you are persecuting. Then Saul asked a second question in verse 6. He said, Lord, what shall I do? I dare somebody to put it in the chat. Lord, what shall I do? Or on the road of Damascus, you're going to have more questions than you have answers. You want to know if you're on the road to Damascus, it's because you got more questions than you got answers. Who should I marry? What should I do after the pandemic? Should I go back into the building? Who are you, Lord, and what shall I do? Those are the two most important questions you will ever ask in your life. Who am I? And who are you is in relation to who he is. John, you cannot discover who you are until you discover who he is. On the road to Damascus, there is Savior discovery and there is self-discovery. The beginning, my God, I feel like preaching here. The beginning of self-discovery is when I can see God for who he is. Because when I see God for who he is when I can see myself for who I am. Ooh, I feel like preaching right here. Come on, somebody put it in the chat. God, show me who you are. Because when I can see who you are, then I can see who I am. I do not know who I am apart from you. I don't have an understanding of who I am apart from you. I cannot comprehend who I am apart from you. I need to see you. Is there anybody up the sound of my voice? Put a heart over your head or put it in the chat. I need to see you with all your glory. I need to see you with all your power. I need to see you with all your presence. Because when I see you, I see myself. Who am I preaching to? I say, when I see you, I see myself. I need somebody to put it in the chat. When I see you, I see myself. When I see you, I see I'm a chosen generation. I'm a royal priesthood. I'm a peculiar person. I'm the head and not the tail. Somebody tell God, show me your glory. Paul asked the question. Paul, who is Saul, asked the question. He said, Lord, who are you and what would you have me to do? Somebody, I dare you to ask the question. What would you have me to do? And there's about 1,000 of you at the sound of my voice that God told me as soon as you ask that question, I'm going to show you. Look what the Bible says. Look what Saul, he said, Lord, what would you have me to do? And the question that Saul asked, we revealed the beginning of a new mindset. It begins the process of conversion. This is the beginning of conversion. This is the beginning of personal transformation. It's when you dare to ask the hard question, what would you have me to do? When you begin to ask that question, it's the beginning of identifying with your purpose. It's the beginning of personal transformation. It's the beginning of what we call a personal conversion. The answer, listen, this is going to bless many of y'all daily. The answer he received is not complete. Oh, I got word to tell you that sometime God will give you an incomplete answer. Oh, Susan, did you catch that? Sometime God will give you an incomplete answer, Sister Dent. Tasha, you want a complete answer before you move to Georgia. But sometime God will give you an incomplete answer. All he tells Saul is get up and go to Damascus and stay there, and I'll tell you the rest. Did y'all catch the revelation? Go to Dubai and stay there, and I'll tell you the rest. Buy the house, and after you buy the house, I'll tell you the rest. Start the business, and after you start the business, I'll tell you the rest. Start the church, and after you start the church, I'll tell you the rest. Teresha, start the organization, and after you start it, I'll tell you the rest. You see, God wants to know if you can be obedient in the small things before he give you the big thing. Somebody put it in the chat. Ooh, my. I see you, Myra. Yeah, you talking about God give me $1 million. And God said, if you can't sow with $1, you won't sow with $1 million. If you won't tithe with $1, you won't tithe with $1 million. Because if you can be faithful with the small things, I'm faithful in my basement. So I expect God to give me a building. I need somebody to put it in the chat. I'm not waiting till I get a building to preach. I'm preaching in my basement because I want God to know you can trust me in my basement. I need somebody to put it in the chat. God, you can trust me with a hoopty while I'm waiting on the Mercedes. God, you can trust me in an apartment while I'm waiting for the house. God, you can trust me with the little while I'm waiting on the big. Somebody put it in the chat. God, you can trust me. Get up, go to your house, and then I'll tell you the rest. It's an incomplete answer. The answer he received is not complete. It simply told him to get up, go into the city, and you will be told what you must do. As the light disappeared, Saul is facing a new awareness. Oh my goodness, Dr. Younger, he's facing a new awareness. Prelo, he's got a spiritual awakening. God, give it back to me. He's facing a new awareness. He's got a spiritual awakening. And don't miss this, John, don't miss this, Miss Yvonne. He can no longer see physically, but he can see spiritually. Ooh, the road to Damascus. You are going to have an insight. You are going to have revelation. vision. My goodness, I dare you to put it in the chat. I may not be able to see physically, but don't get it twisted. I can see spiritually. I may be blind like Stevie Wonder physically, but my spiritual senses is awakened. I don't know who I'm preaching to. I can see more clearly than I've ever seen in my life. In this pandemic, on this road to Damascus, I can see more clearly. I need somebody to put it in the chat. I can see who's for me and who's against me. I can see who my haters are and who my prayers are. Are there anybody at the sound of my voice who said, when I come out of this pandemic, Nikki Green, when I finish with this road of Damascus, I can see clearly? Who am I talking to? Gloria and Leon, put it in the chat. I can see clearly. I don't need eyes to see. I've got insight. What did I say? I got insight. Come on, put it in the chat. I've got insight. Paul is physically blind, Antoinette. He's physically blind, but he's spiritually awakened. My goodness, he's as blind as a bat physically, but his senses. Put your hands on your eyes, because I declare that God is going to give you supernatural sight. You are going to see what you've never seen before, so you can do what you've never done before, so you can have what you never had before. Come on, put it in the chat. God, open my eyes. Open my spiritual eyes. Open my eyes so I can see that there is more for me than there are against me. Open my eyes so I can see what my enemy is. Open my eyes so I can see what I got in the spirit. Well, I dare somebody to put it in the chat. God, open my eyes. Here it is. He's on the road to Damascus and he is blind. And the Bible says as he gets to this place. Oh God, are y'all still there? Put a heart over your head. It's going to mess y'all up. John. The Bible said he's at a crossroad on the road to Damascus. He's on what? He's on a crossroad. Because now he has not gotten to Damascus yet, Dr. Younger. He's between Jerusalem and Damascus. And it's at this point that he has to make a decision, Elder Johnson. Do I go back to Jerusalem and regroup? Or Jacqueline, do I go to Damascus? To what's my purpose? Somebody put it in the chat. I'm at a crossroad. Come on, I'm at a crossroad. Do I go back into the marriage and get somebody, or do I forge ahead with the divorce? Somebody put it in the chat. I'm at a crossroad. Do I go back into the building, to the job, or do I start my own business? Put it in the chat. I'm at a crossroad. Do I go back to the old friends who hang out on Friday night with her, who was not even helping me achieve anything, or do I forge forward? Somebody is at a crossroad. Do I go back to the old me, or do I go ahead? Put it in. You are at the point of decision. But I'm so glad. I said, I'm so glad Saul made the decision. Saul decided, I'd rather go forward. Because listen, this is what Saul learned. He learned that life is about discovery and it's not about certainty. Somebody put it in the chat. I said, life is about discovery. You can go back, Billy, but the only thing that's behind you is what you're already done, is where you're already been. That's what's called certainty. But we were not created for certainty. We were created for discovery. On the road to Damascus, you are getting ready to discover something that you never discovered before. You're getting ready to see what you've never seen before. Is there anybody out there who want to go on a discovery? This past weekend I took Cam and Chloe somewhere they never been before. We went sailing and I said to them, the word for today is discovery. Cam asked me 99 questions. He said, what if we fall off the ship? What if the ship flips over? What if we end up in the water? I said, at least we tried something new. Because Cam, life is not about certainty. Put it in the chat. Life is about discovery. And the Lord told me to tell 25 of you, you're playing it too safe. You want to stay in Jerusalem. But I dare you to put it in the chat. I want to go where I've never gone before. So I can do what I've never done before. So I can see what I've never seen before. I'm at a cross. Come on, put it in. I'm at a crossroad. I'm in the valley of decision. I'm in the valley. Who am I preaching to? Put a heart over your head. Who am I preaching to? I'm in the valley of decision. I'm in a crossroad, but Paul decided. He'd rather be Paul than Saul. You see, Saul is certainty, but Paul is discovery. Oh, my God, my God. I said Saul is certainty. I know Saul. I was living with Saul. I was born Saul, but I don't know what Paul is going to be. But I dare somebody to put it in the chat. Paul is going to be greater than Saul. I need somebody to confess to yourself. I'd rather be Paul than live being Saul. I already know Saul. I've been living with Saul the last 52 years, but I want a glimpse of Paul. I feel glory right here. I need somebody to put it in the chat. I'm on my way to becoming what I've never been before, so I can do what I've never done before, so I can have what I never had before. And right there, Solomon, on the road to Damascus, Paul made a decision. Right there, he made a decision. If I'm going to die, let me die as Paul, but I'm not going to die as Saul. Who am I preaching to this morning? That you are at the road of decision, and you made up your mind. If you're going to die, at least die moving forward and not falling backwards. Who am I preaching to? I need somebody to put it in the chat. I don't even need you to clap. I just need you to cash app. Put it in the chat. If I'm going to die, let me die as Paul, but not as Saul. If I'm going to fail, let me fail forward and not fail backwards. If I'm going to fall in the ocean, let me fall in the ocean on my way somewhere and not on the shoreline. He made a decision that he was going to move forward. But here's another lesson. Just take these lessons. Listen, on the road, oh God, this is going to mess you up. You're going to tear your house up. On the road of Damascus, the Bible said a light shines. He falls off his horse. He hears a voice. But Solomon, don't miss verse 8. It's right there in the text. You'll see it on the screen. The men around him heard the voice, but they stood speechless and they saw no one. Oh, John, you ready for this? You ready for this? Listen, the road to Damascus, it's a personal sport. What did I say? It's an individual sport. It's an individual thing. I got something to tell you. Lean forward. The change that's about to happen in your life, everybody won't understand it. I see you, Frederica. I said the change that's about to take place, John, everybody is not going to sign off on it. Would you put it in the chat? And that's okay with me. You got to be okay with people not liking you. You got to be okay with people not agreeing with you. You got to be okay with people not standing you. You got to, come on, put it in the chat. You got to be. It amazed me, Solomon, that with all of this light and this loud voice, only Saul hears the voice. My Bella, only Saul hears, or y'all gotta catch this. Listen, on the road to Damascus, it's not group therapy. Come on, put it in the chat. Yes, we are in a group, but it's not group therapy. You are responsible for your own spiritual transformation. I dare you to put it in the chat. I am responsible for my own on personal transformation. If you don't get nothing out of this word, it ain't gonna bother me. You're responsible for getting your own personal transformation. I just got 40 minutes with you. You got 7 days with yourself, and you haven't grown an inch, and you want me to grow you in 40 minutes? The devil is a liar. Put it in the chat. I'm responsible to feed myself. I'm responsible to grow my spirit and to grow my mind. In fact, let me tell you what I am, Stephanie. I'm your life coach. Put it in the chat. My pastor is my life coach. I'm not your mama. I'm not your daddy. I'm your life coach. My job is to show you and to help you identify where God is moving. But I can't force you to eat. I can't force you to prayer meeting. I can't force you to Bible study. You got to decide for yourself. You are at a crossroad. Whether you want to be a babe in Christ or if you want to grow in your faith. Are y'all catching this revelation? There is nobody else on the road. Lord, I gotta hurry along. There's nobody else on the road. There's nobody else on the road. There's nobody on the road with Saul. Rather, there's all these people on the road with Saul. But the Bible said that only who hears it? Only here Paul hears it. No other person around to hear it. What's the lesson? The lesson is, number one, the road to Damascus is personal. But I gotta say this. I gotta say this before I wind up. I gotta say this. I've gotta say this. The Holy Spirit told me, don't miss saying it this week. In verse 7, the Bible said, they heard the voice, but they saw no one. Listen, listen, listen. The people who are on the road to Damascus with you are spectators and not participators. Oh, God. I know this is too rich for y'all. What did I say? They are spectators and not participators. Participators. Yes, they can cheer you along. Yes, they can support you. Yes, they can move you along. But they are what? 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 They are. They are spectators and not participators. Here's the thing I want you to catch, and I'll pick it up next week. Here it is. Here it is, Solomon. Here's the revelation, Pastor Shannon. Here's the revelation. You know you're on the road to Damascus because you lost some folks. I'm going to pick that up right there. Put a pin right there next week. You lost some folks. The road to Damascus is an alone journey. I'm in church, but I'm alone. I hang out with folks at happy hour, but I'm alone. I did not say lonely. I did not say lonely. The road to Damascus. You know it is. I'm just giving you signs that you know you on this. Because listen, oh God, this is going to mess y'all up. The people who helped you while you were traveling on the road sometimes will desert you. Not by the time you get to Acts chapter 9, verse number 10, Deacon Boswell, all the people who travel with Saul, he's nowhere to be found. Frederica, they're nowhere to be found. Now I'm gonna help you, church folks, cause you've been agonizing why some people had to walk away from you. You've been agonizing why some people had to leave you. Lean forward, let me tell you why. It's because they are on their own journey. And sometimes we can travel the same road, but not at the same pace. Sometimes we can travel the same road, but Sheila, it's not the same pace. Cam and Chloe are 6 years. They're twins, and I get them every weekend. And Cam and Chloe has a schedule. On Friday, they want Chick-fil-A. On Saturday, they want McDonald's. And this morning, because I kept them, they want Greenies. What did I say? Friday, they want Chick-fil-A. Saturday, they want McDonald's. And Sunday, they want Green Passion. And so Friday, we went through Chick-fil-A. I got them Chick-fil-A. On Saturday, I got them McDonald's. And you know what has started happening, Carletta? Every time I ordered something for them in Chick-fil-A, I got some for me. And then I ordered at McDonald's on Saturday and I got some for me. And then I got on the scale. I'm like, wait a minute, how come I put on 2 pounds in the last 2 weeks? And these young whippersnapper, they're still the same weight. It's because we're on the same road, but we are different stage. You see, their metabolism is high. Mine's in my 50s. Okay, but it's slowing down. So if I keep on eating, Deacon Ed, the way they're eating, I'm gonna blow up. Hello, somebody. Not in a positive way. So I've got to make sure I eat according to my age and not according to theirs. My time is up. Father, on this road to Damascus, we are at a crossroad, but right here, right now, we make a decision. As painful as it is, we're not going back. Come on, put it in the chat. I won't go back. I'm not going back to that cussing Saul, that depressing Saul, that angry Saul. I'm not going back, because what's ahead of me is greater than what's behind me. Oh, let's have a eulogy and let's bury the old you. Put it in the chat. I don't want to see this old me again. And so, ashes to ashes. Dearly beloved, the Lord has taken. Dust to dust, ashes to ashes, because what I'm becoming is greater than what I was. Hey, everybody, start waving Saul goodbye. What's your Saul? Come on, wave it. What is your Saul? That mean Saul, that impatient Saul, that angry Saul. Come on, whatever that Saul is, whatever. Come on, start waving your Saul goodbye. Come on, wave that saw. Wave that saw. If you sit and text to your spouse, your significant other, look at them and say, you remember that saw that you couldn't stand? You won't see it. This devil, you see today. You won't see it again. Come on, bury it. Bury it, bury it. This devil, you see today. You will not see it again. Oh, God. Oh, my God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. If you were blessed, come on, put a heart over your head, put it in the chat. But maybe there's somebody that's sound of my voice. You're not saved. You don't belong to a church. And you'll have to be a believer today, want to connect with our church. The information on how you can is all on the screen. It's all on the screen. It's all on the screen. Now you can keep on watching us if you like. For those of you on Facebook, YouTube, or you can join us by being a part of our virtual service. We call it VLive 120. All the information on how you can be a part of that service is on the screen. And just join us. And don't just watch us, but worship with us. And all you need to do is follow everything on the screen. In Jesus' name. Well, maybe you're saved and maybe you belong to a church and you were blessed today. Let's get ready. Let's get ready to give back to the Lord something that the Lord has given to us. I want to encourage you, if you don't belong to our church, don't give us your tithe. Give that to your local church. But my goodness, you can sow something if you are blessed by the word of God. The information of how you can give is on the screen. The information of how you can give is all on the screen. The information is on the screen of how you can give. You can give through Givelify. You can read, text the give, Cash App, however, Zelle, the information on how you can give is on the screen. Next week, I'm going to pick it back up, because I'm going to talk about the people that you're going to lose on the way. But I'm going to talk about the people who go on their way to help you. On the road to Damascus, Dr. Butler, there's somebody who helped Paul and there's somebody who healed Paul. Oh, my God. What did I say? Help and heal.